Hey guys, welcome back to another Musical Monday. We only have one more after this, so let's just make it worth it and get right into it. We have pop today. There's this a really good song. It's called Don't Go Wasting Your Emotions by ABBA. It was released in 1980 and it's obviously the pop genre. This is a really good song when you want to have like a dance party or sing-offs and like karaoke. It is an older song, so I feel like not many people in our age and day listen to it, but I really like it and I think you guys would too. It's definitely catchy and an upbeat song. It's smooth and it talks about love, and like even the title says don't go wasting your emotions. So like I kind of feel like it's saying don't say or do things that would hurt you, and like just save like your emotions and your feelings for those who stick around and those who love you. So I don't know, you tell me what you think. I hope you guys enjoy.
Summer, the season of ice cream, beach days, hot weather, and best of all, no school. With school ending in just about 2 weeks, many of you are probably planning for the season. So here are some ways to spend your summer productively as a high school student. My first tip is to get a job, internship, or volunteer. All of these are great for getting real-world experience and also wonderful opportunities to get involved with your community and meet people. My second tip is to tour colleges. Especially if you're a current junior, you should start off by making a list of the things you're looking for in colleges and then do research online. Once you do have a few candidates pinpointed, you can either tour them virtually or actually plan a trip to them. Third, do a summer camp. Summer camps are a great way to meet new people, especially those with similar interests as you. Summer camps are very broad. There are cheap and expensive ones, 3-week overnight camps and day camps, and camps for every type of hobby. You could do a chamber music camp, a research camp, a college course camp, or even just a fun outdoor camp. I would really recommend them just because they offer a unique experience you're not going to get from school and some unforgettable memories. My fourth tip is to learn something you're passionate about. We often get too caught up in school to really focus on hobbies and interests, so it's always fulfilling to dive into things like knitting or music or philosophy or whatever we may be interested in when we have time. Plus, you never know what your hobbies or passions might blossom into. Fifth, read. Reading is such an important thing to do, especially as our attention spans get wrecked by apps like TikTok and so on. Reading allows us to critically think and explore the perspectives of timeless authors from Shakespeare to Stephen King to Ray Bradbury. Reading is also great for winding down before bedtime. And on to our last tip, relax. Nothing is going to charge you up for the next year better than taking vacations, going out with your friends, and most importantly, sleep. So make sure you squeeze in a lot of relaxing into your summer. As usual, thanks for watching and see you all next week for our very last episode this year of Tip Tuesday.
Welcome to another and the penultimate word of the week, because school ends in... Actually, I have no idea when school ends, but it's soon. In celebration, we've got another word. This week's word is solicitude. It's a noun and its definition is the state of being concerned and anxious, or attentive care and protectiveness. So solicitude is essentially a synonym for concern, and it can basically take two paths. It can take a more negative, anxiety-inducing path, or it can take a more compassionate, caring path. On one hand, you could have growing solicitude about a test grade that's making you really nervous, or you could have solicitude about your friend's well-being because you are a compassionate person and you care about your friend. So solicitude can be a really genuine, sweet word, and hopefully you all don't experience too much solicitude in these last one, two, three, whatever, weeks as school closes up. I wish you all the best. In the meantime, I'm going to combat my growing solicitude for my brownie craving by eating a brownie that is conveniently right here. Yep. That's all.
What's your name?
Anderson Rickman.
And how are you today, Anderson?
I'm doing all right.
All right. What grade are you in?
I am a junior.
Very cool. How would your closest friends at North describe you?
A little bit goofy, cynical maybe.
What are you involved in here at North?
I am in the Treasure Island production, and I'm also in Improvity.
Very cool. How do you hope others see you?
I hope others see me as someone they can trust, and someone who can give them a good laugh.
Aw, I love that. What is one thing you wish you would have known as a freshman?
I wish I would have known not to take a study hall freshman year so that I could do more elective courses and see what I liked.
Yeah. How has your outlook on life developed in the last year?
It's really shown me to take a bit of a more positive outlook and always be ready for things to change.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. That's really important. And what is one piece of advice your past self would give to you?
Past self? Keep trucking.
Hey North, welcome back to Future Friday. This is our second to last normal week of the school year, which is super crazy.
Agreed. This year is almost at an end, but that doesn't mean that we don't have anything to update you guys about.
This week, the North Triathlon was held. Melissa and I were on a team together, so that was pretty fun. We crushed it. Hashtag slate.
Congrats to everyone who participated.
The Club Carnival was also held this Wednesday in the Commons, and it was held during all three lunch hours. Everyone says I do my three weirds, but like that, but I don't, like, anyways.
Okay, after editing, I've come to the conclusion that I do this too. This is like, if I'm like counting 1, 2, 3, 4, but like, wait. No, it's like this.
There are a bunch of great clubs in North, and the Carnival offered a great opportunity to help raise awareness of them. If you saw any booths you enjoyed, remember to try and join those clubs next year.
Senior prom was also this Saturday. To all of the people who attended, we hope you had a very groovy time.
You're so close to the end of the year. It feels like it's gone by so fast.
With the end of the year fast approaching, we hope you're able to take the next few weeks to appreciate the people that are closest to you and enjoy the end of the year.
We'll see you next week, North. Next week will be our final issue of The Spark. So for the second to last time...
Get you on the flippity flop!
By the way, I let her do this. Next week, it will be me.